A good pair of genes can make all the difference to your wheat crop. Now, before you get excited about fashion trends, the genes in question are YR18 and YR29, and what they deliver is adult plant resistance to one of wheat's greatest fungal diseases.
We can see exactly what the effects of those genes are on the stripe rust.
In late 2012, Nick Poole introduced us to this GRDC-funded research into the interaction of fungicide and adult plant resistance on cereal rust. Now, a couple of crop cycles later, Sydney University's Plant Breeding Institute at Cobbity, in collaboration with FAR Australia, is producing results that will impact fungicide management practices.
The key message at this stage is that, particularly with two adult plant resistance genes designated as being part of your genetic background, we have only the need for spraying once, and that fungicide application looks to have more flexibility as to when we apply it in stem elongation than if we were dealing with a cultivar that was much more susceptible, where a two-spray approach would be essential.
And while adult plant resistance genes might only bring protection against rust in a plant's later growth stages, the resistance is more difficult for the pathogen to overcome.
And that's a big positive. It means that if we put adult plant resistance into a variety, we can be more confident it's going to stay effective for longer.
In one part of the Cobbity research program, new chemistry is being trialled on commercial wheat cultivars carrying APR genes.
And looking at how these newer generation fungicides like SDHIs, like strobilurins, how they interact with those commercial varieties carrying these APR genes. And we're working on two APR genes specifically, the YR18 gene and the YR29 gene.
However, commercial lines can carry unidentified genes that could affect rust resistance. So it was extremely important the second part of the program used near isogenic lines to which two known APR genes could be added.
So we're trying to effectively isolate the effect, for want of a better description, of those adult plant resistance genes in the same genetic background. And that's what we're doing in the trial right here in the older variety Avocet, which is extremely susceptible, but in this particular case we have near isogenic lines that have introduced one APR gene and then two.
When the Avocet lines were exposed to stripe rust with no fungicide protection, the impact of the APR genes was clearly visible on the plant's leaves, its solar panels.
This is a completely susceptible cultivar with no adult plant resistance. This, in the same genetic background, in this case Avocet, is where we've got one adult plant resistance gene. And this is where we've introduced two adult plant resistance genes. And you can clearly see, just like the effect of a fungicide, the genetics here is preserving our solar panels as green solar panels.
It's these near isogenic lines with their known traits that allows the research team to isolate the impact of adult plant resistance.
And I think it's really important to emphasise that whilst our ability to understand what's going on has improved immensely over the last 30 years, we still have genes, particularly adult plant resistance genes, that we can't identify or we haven't identified. And so we see effects in the field that we know there must be other APR genes there, but actually we don't know precisely which ones they are.
And APR genes alone can't offer complete protection against rust.
You can actually get some reduction in yield in some varieties carrying adult plant resistance, and this is where there is a need for integrated management with the use of fungicides.
While this GRDC-funded research continues, there is action growers can take, according to the project leaders: maintain a fungicide strategy and only sow rust-resistant varieties.